Right now, I'm standing in the United States, but I'm actually extremely close to Canada. So close, in fact, that my phone is connected to a cell tower on the other side of the border. Does that matter? Well, if I were to take a photo right now, that image would be synced using the Canadian provider's network, which means that it becomes subject to Canadian laws regarding security and privacy and ownership of data. Then, when it crosses the border again to be stored on my sync server, that becomes subject to US laws. In this case, because it's the United States and Canada, the laws are pretty harmonious. But that question, the idea of where's my data going and what laws govern it, is the core concern when you're planning for data sovereignty. Let's talk about it. Data sovereignty is a legal concept arising from the idea of nation-state sovereignty, which has been the foundation of the current international order for the last couple hundred years. Basically, data sovereignty holds that if data is created inside the borders of a given country or jurisdiction, then the laws of that jurisdiction get to govern the ways that that data can be used, how that data gets stored, and when the government can access that data. You're likely familiar with some of the more widely publicized data privacy and security laws, such as GDPR or California's CCPA. However, every jurisdiction views data that's subject to its laws a little bit differently. That is why businesses need to include data sovereignty in their decision-making when it comes to choosing cloud partners. It's really easy to forget it sometimes, but the cloud is a physical place. It's a bunch of them, actually. Every time you upload something from your laptop, your phone, or your tablet, it goes over the internet to a building with a boatload of servers inside of it. As a business, you need to have certainty that the servers your data is going to be stored on are compliant with the data sovereignty regulations of the jurisdictions that govern your data. For instance, if it's data created in the European Union, it likely needs to be stored on servers within the Schengen zone, and you also probably need to be compliant with GDPR. Even though it gets pretty complicated pretty quickly, as a business owner or a consumer, there's good news. And that is that most of the time, you don't need to think about data sovereignty all that much. That's part of what you pay your cloud provider to think about. Whether it's an organization like CrashPlan or a larger hyperscaler like Microsoft, Amazon, or Google, there will be options for your business to comply with all applicable rules for your jurisdiction. What it does mean, though, is that when you're partnering with a cloud provider for storage, backup, or really anything, you'll want to choose an organization that matches your global footprint. If you do business within the territory of a single jurisdiction, then a local option is totally viable. If you have a global footprint with businesses and employees located in multiple jurisdictions, then you'll want to choose a partner with a matching footprint that can work with you to manage all your needs. If you want to find out more about data sovereignty or some backup solutions that help you keep on the right track, check out the link in the description. I'll catch you in the next video, but until then, I'm going to get back to playing in the snow. Cheers.